What's up everyone, I hope everyone is doing well. So in this video, we are going to be talking about a lot of topics, and part of this video, a good chunk of this video, I'm going to be talking about who we should sign for our Suarez replacement. It's a very important topic because right now we are in the middle of the season. Suarez is out for the rest of this season, so it's a good time to be talking about this. So yeah, I'm in a pretty good mood also because we did win yesterday 1-0 and we won in style. So there's a lot to look forward to. I'm very focused. I know Barcelona's focused right now. So yeah, and also if you're new to this channel, you guys know what I'm about to say. I'm going to be posting this on YouTube. So if you're new to this channel, please like, subscribe, comment. I'm happy you are here. Welcome to the channel. And so yeah, I'll see you guys in the comment section below. Enjoy the video. Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. So today we are going to speak about a lot of topics, and we are first going to talk about the American soccer player Conrad De La Fuente. So he is a 18-year-old American soccer player who plays for Barcelona B. He has been developing in the Barça youth system since 2014, and sources have told ESPN that Barcelona have made United States youth international Conrad De La Fuente an ultimatum as negotiations continue over a new contract. So Barcelona have been in contact with De La Fuente over the past few months. In 2019, Barcelona did offer a 3-year contract in the fall of 2019. His contract is set to expire in the summer of 2020. And De La Fuente has yet to make a decision because his interest has turned to Hertha Berlin. This is a club that has appointed Jurgen Klinsmann back in the fall of 2019, which is probably De La Fuente's main motive to join that club. With De La Fuente yet to decide what he wants to do, this is what made Barcelona improve their offer, which is like to improve their wages or maybe set out a set plan on how to progress and how to get into the Barcelona first team. But since it is an ultimatum, if he does not accept it, Barcelona will take action and say, hey, look, you will not play for the rest of this season and then you can go on your way, which is basically terminating the contract. And to me, Barcelona just wants to push De La Fuente to make a decision. To be honest, I would really like De La Fuente to actually leave Barcelona for two reasons. One is because Barcelona's youth academy is extremely stacked with talent. It's saturated up top, and there is a lot of amazing talent competing to try and get into that first team. And we have seen multiple young talents get put into the back burner and loaned out into a team outside of Spain. And I know that De La Fuente has taken note of that. We have seen a lot of Barça B Academy players get pushed back, and then once we do push them back and we sign another star player from another club, that is what Barcelona has been doing over the past 4 to 5 years. So I can see why De La Fuente is in a place to make a decision. Like, he doesn't know if he wants to progress through this youth system or go into a German club where he is guaranteed to get first team playing time. And we have seen good case studies of successful American players thriving in the German league. We have players like Pulisic, who started to play at Dortmund and then he became a star player there and then moved to Chelsea. Then we have Tyler Adams, who plays for Leipzig, who are a team that is currently number one in the German league, and he did start in the past 2 matches, so he is progressing, he is becoming better, so he has a lot of potential to be a star player, and I believe that is what De La Fuente wants to do. So it would be a great move for De La Fuente to move to that German club. I highly recommend that. Now moving on to Neymar, and we all know what I'm about to talk about when it comes to Neymar. So it has been reported by El Confidencial that Neymar has asked several Barcelona players about Setién's mythology. So basically he's asking like Messi or like Piqué or Sergio Busquets, like, is Quique Setién training you guys well? How do you guys feel during training? Is his style of training really good? Is his style of play related to Barcelona's DNA? Like, stuff like that, you know? El Confidencial is in most cases a reliable source, but honestly, I don't know what to think about this rumor, because when it comes to Neymar's rumors, you can't tell what's real and what's fake. Neymar is a person that's very open, he's emotional, he's not afraid to speak out on how or what he feels. We have seen Neymar try and publicly try and push a move away from PSG in order to move back to FC Barcelona. So anything can happen when it comes to this player. He can say anything. We know how he is. We also have seen Neymar hang out with his former teammates at Suarez's anniversary. He's just someone that is not afraid of the consequences or people's opinions, which makes me believe that he is not afraid to send a simple text to Messi asking how's training under Quique
Quique Setién. So I could see Neymar asking Messi this, but I don't get how reports like this find stuff like this out, which makes it very skeptical. But since we are talking about Neymar, since this is a hot topic, and I know that a lot of you guys do want Neymar to come, I want to speak about Neymar for a little bit, and you guys know what I'm going to say. And I'm still going to lean on the side of not bringing Neymar in, and I'm going to stand firm on that. And it's not because I believe that he's a snake, or like I believe that he betrayed us on, like, you know, like what you guys have said in the comment section. But for me, I'm not like that. I believe he does deserve a second chance. Everyone deserves a second chance. He is a good player, he's an amazing talent, and I would welcome him with open arms, but it just doesn't make sense for the club. And if Neymar does want to come in, three actions have to be taken place from FC Barcelona, at least for me. And one is to sell Dembele. The second action is to forget about signing Lautaro Martinez. And the third action will be to sell Paris. And this is all for the purpose of leaving space in that front three. We haven't even begun about talking about the money aspect of things. So it's very complicated. A lot of sacrifices have to be made in order for Neymar to come back. So in my opinion, now we should be thinking for the long term, sign the players that we believe can benefit us for the next 5 to 6 years. And I'm going to keep saying that until the summer of 2020, because who knows what's gonna happen in that summer. But yeah, that's just my opinion. Now I want to move on to the Barcelona technical director meeting. Mundo Deportivo have reported that the sports management team of Barcelona will meet today to make a decision on possible incorporations and exits during the winter transfer window. So to me here, it says right here that they are going to discuss stuff like Vidal's situation and Rakitic's situation, but I specifically want to talk about Suarez's replacement, and I believe that is the main reason why they organized that meeting, because Barcelona's idea is to sign a temporary striker. And what options are Barcelona looking at to replace Luis Suarez this season? There has been reports about Pedro Rodriguez coming in, Dani Olmo, Paco Alacer, even a player like Vela from LAFC. But for what? What is the main reason why Barcelona wants to sign a replacement for Luis Suarez? Because look, Barcelona's idea is to sign a temporary striker, and that never works out for the club. We have seen what happened last year when we signed Kevin Prince Boateng. He provided nothing. He was an absolute waste of time and money, and literally we got to a point where last season, if we did not have Suarez, we would have Kevin Prince Boateng. So Messi's main partnership will be Kevin Prince Boateng. Is that really what the club is about? Is that really what we turned into? And Barcelona is looking to do the exact same thing and put themselves in the exact same situation. It's like they haven't learned from their mistakes. It's not a good idea to sign a temporary striker. That never works out. Signing a temporary striker will waste you money and time. And not just waste time, but take away the time from Ansu Fati and Dembele. And if you're going to take away these minutes from these players, at least have that striker be effective when coming on the pitch and actually bring results for FC Barcelona. It's like the club forgets that they have so many options up front who are versatile enough, who can adjust to any system. We have talked about this before. There's like three different options, three different lineups on what we can do with Ansu Fati, Griezmann, Messi, and Dembele. What I'm really looking forward to is for Setién to actually say something and give his opinion on this situation. He is a man that likes to get into these conversations. He wants to have a voice. He is the only man that knows how to really function this team. He even stated himself that he will analyze this situation if they will need a backup striker or not this season. And if we look at this report from Cadena Ser, Barça's objective is to have sold players for an amount of 100 million at the end of the season, having already earned about 50 million from sales and loans of Malcolm, Coutinho, and Rafinha. Rakitic or another player could leave in the winter. Then if we continue here, Lautaro Martinez is the most liked striker by Barcelona, and the player has a release clause of 110 million euros. Barcelona's initial idea was to not sign a striker in January, but the managerial change and Suarez's injury might change that. However, the financial aspect is a big obstacle. So if we are going to sign a striker, at least not have it be a temporary one. Let's sign a striker that we know is going to be with us for the next 5 years. But for now, in this season, we shouldn't sign one. We have the players in order for us to be successful to win the UCL. I'm a big believer in our own players. We need the right system. We need the right coach. We need the right instructions in order for this system to work. We don't have to spend so much money on all these players. Now, moving on to my last topic, which is Dembele. Dembele did return from Qatar a few days ago. He did attend in the game yesterday between Granada and Barcelona. And today, he did train alone in Barcelona to complete his last phase of recovery, and he is expected to be back before the game against Napoli for the round of 16. So let's hope that he recovers fast and he recovers well and he comes back stronger than ever. So that's it for today's Barcelona's daily news. That is what's going on in the club. So thank you guys for watching. I appreciate all the love and support, and I'll see you guys next time.